Hello, welcome to netvn channel. In this video I will show you how to turn an old computer into a speed test server. You can test the speed between two computers over the internet. You will know latency, upload speed, download speed. I will use Xorin OS for my old laptop. As recommended, the Xorin Lite operating system can be installed on computers that are 15 years old. I have preloaded the Xorin Lite OS installation ISO file to create the USB installer. To create the Xorin installer I use Rufus. You select the prepared USB stick in ISO file to create the installer. When creating the Xorin installer, the data on the USB stick will be destroyed. After about 10 minutes, the installation will complete. You can safely remove the installation USB stick to make sure the installer is not faulty. You bring the USB stick and plug it into the target computer and start installing Xorin OS. You set the boot order to USB storage. Every computer has a different way of setting up the boot order. With my old computer, when I booted, I pressed F2 repeatedly. You save the boot order settings and restart the computer. Next, you follow the same steps as me to install Xorin on the target computer. Set up the keyboard. I choose the English keyboard. I choose to erase the data on the hard drive. You will be asked to create an admin account. You write down this account to use in the next steps. Once fully set up, the computer will be installed. It will take about 15 minutes to complete the operating system installation. Now remove the USB stick and restart the computer. Xorin OS gives you a nice and simple graphical interface. Not only can you create a speed test server, but you can also browse the web, watch YouTube with Xorin OS. Next, I will install LibSpeed on Xorin. You open a command window, update and upgrade the operating system. The update command is sudo apt update. The upgrade command is sudo apt upgrade. The next command is sudo apt install git. Next, you install Apache and PHP. Sudo apt get install Apache to PHP. cd/var/www. Next, you download the necessary files for LibSpeed. Sudo git clone https://github.com /dolphintl speed test. You have many options for your server, but I choose example single server gauges.html for my server. Sudo cp example single server gauges.html index.html. Next, you change the path to the index.html file of Apache. You edit the configuration file of Apache sudo nano0000default.conf. You change the path to /var/www/speedtest. Don't forget to save the configuration file. For the changes to take effect, restart the Apache service. To find your computer's IP address, use the command hostname I. Next, you check if LibSpeed is working or not. You open the web browser available on Zorin and enter the IP address of the computer. A simple graphical interface of LibSpeed appears. You just need to click Start to test the speed. You should edit the index.html file to show you. Sudo nano index.html. Like here, I change the title to netvn speed test. Next, you restart the Apache service. Then you refresh your web browser, you will see the title change from another computer on the local network. You can test the speed between two computers. But if you want to test the speed between two computers over the internet, you need to do a few more steps. First, you set up a static IP address for the target computer. I set the IP address to 10.11.32.66. On the router, you forward port 80. Because port 80 coincides with the router's management port, I changed the management port to 8080. In this case, I forward port 80 to IP address 10.11.32.66. Next, you use DuckDNS to update your public IP address and get a free domain name. You create a free domain name. My free domain is netvnspeedtest.duckdns.org. In previous videos I showed you how to install DuckTunes with Ubuntu server operating system. In this video the installation will be different because Xorn has a graphical interface. You can still use the command line installation like the previous videos. You download the file as instructed and copy it to your operating system's home directory. When executing the file, you will be asked to update the domain name. My domain name is netvnspeedtest.dns.org. Next, you update your own token. Each account has a different token. After updating the domain name and token, you will receive a successful public IP address update notification. So with just an old computer, you can create your own speed test server. Thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe.